Good afternoon, YouTube. So we're gonna test this pump that I picked up for the Breville Barista Express. So this is supposed to be a 52 watt ULKA model EF type EFP5. And I figured what I would do is test this pump out before I put it in, make sure it works. And then I wanna see how far it shoots water just to do a ad hoc pressure and flow test. So what I'll do is I've got my Cliff quick test here. So I've got that plugged into the GFCI outlet. And then I've got a little cable harness hooked up to the pump. So when I close the quick test, the pump will start. And then right over here, I've got a bucket of water and a clear PVC tube dropped into the water. So we'll suck some water up the tube, out the pump, and then we'll try to shoot the water out of the small tube and see how far it goes. So let me switch over here, get lined up. So what I'm going to do is close the Cliff quick test and we'll see if the pump works here. And there we go. It's sucking up water. Let it build up some pressure there. The far bricks that are under my tomato plants, that's 22 feet, and I was just getting to the base of those blocks. That is the flow and pressure out of this new pump. Once I get the old pump out of the machine, I'll run this same test and just see how far it pumps. Because if the old pump has low pressure, it's probably not going to shoot the water out as far. That'll be a reasonable test of pressure. So yeah, we'll come back and test the old pump once I get it pulled out of the machine and see if there's any difference. Okay, YouTube, so this is the original pump from my Breville Barista Express and got the original safety valve on there. And I've got this plugged into my Cliff quick test so we can supply power and we'll see how far it pumps the water here. Getting about the same distance over there. Maybe a little bit less. The new pump was getting up onto the bricks on the side of the shed, where this one is getting just short of it. But I think I might see part of the problem right here. If you look, there's water dripping out of this safety valve. So I think it may have actually been this safety valve that was the problem. I don't have the washer in there, so that's gonna leak a little bit, but let me see if I can find a O-ring or something to put in there. Okay, so I found a small O-ring that might seal this up. See if that water is leaking out of the valve or just out of the seal there. That one might be too big, but let's see what happens here. Yeah, maybe that's okay. Yeah, you can see it's still leaking out of the end of that safety valve there. Looks like the pump pressure is okay, but I'm thinking this valve was probably bleeding pressure off. So there's a little clip on there of some sort. Oh, I wonder if this thing is adjustable. Yeah, so this just holds the, it's kind of like a little lock nut. So yes, I read someplace that this thing was possibly adjustable. So maybe that's been the problem with my machine. It's gone through cycles where the pressure gets really low and then it oscillates. The pressure gauge will go up, it'll drop, and it just oscillates between high and low pressure. So I was thinking it was the pump, but it might be this thing. Yeah, because there's probably a little valve and a spring in there, and then this center part pushes harder on the spring, takes more pressure to open. Dang, I'll have to figure out if there's a way to test these. The only thing it might do is take the pump, and you can take this pump head off, and inside here there's an O-ring and a little plastic ball that's the check valve, and that little plastic ball supposedly wears. So I might pick up a rebuild kit for this and then just compare the size of the ball in here to the size of the new ball in the rebuild kit and see if there's any difference. supposedly the little plastic ball gets smaller and smaller and smaller until it doesn't seal up very well anymore. And then that's when you replace it. If I can screw this into the pump and then maybe get something to put into a gauge for this end, because then I could put a pressure gauge on and then let the pump run and see where this thing blows off at, because I'm guessing it's probably something less than 10 bar, which would cut down your espresso brewing pressure. Yeah, if you've had any experience with these, post up in the comment section down below. And if I get any follow-up testing, I'll put those videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.